In this short tutorial, we are gonna fix Windows Explorer not responding problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. I recommend watching the video once before trying the solutions. The first solution consists of two small steps. The first step is to clear the file explorer's history. To do this, we go to search and type file explorer options. Before clearing file explorer's history, select Open File Explorer as this PC. If this PC is already selected, select Home. The reason for this is that Home does not load correctly when opening File Explorer, so we need to change this. After doing this, we delete the File Explorer history. Then click Apply and OK to save the changes we made. The second step is to restart Windows Explorer. With this restart process, we can make Windows Explorer work properly. To do this, we open a Task Manager. After opening Task Manager, we scroll to the bottom. After that, we right-click on Windows Explorer and click on End Task. After doing this, the desktop may be gray like this. This is completely normal. Now, to run Windows Explorer again, we click on Run New Task from the top. Then we type explorer.exe and click OK. As you can see, the desktop is back as it was. This was the first solution. Now you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the problem is not solved, we will move on to the second solution. Also, don't forget to like the video if you haven't already. The second solution is to verify our system files. The problem may be caused by our corrupt system files. If this is the case, verifying our system files will solve the problem. To do this, we go to search and run CMD as admin. There are two codes we need to type in CMD. These codes will be in the description section. You can copy and paste them into CMD from there. After typing the first code, press Enter. Then we type the second code and press Enter again. This process will take some time as it scans our system files. The verification process is over. Now we need to restart our computer. After restarting your computer, you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the problem is not solved, we will move on to the last solution. The last solution comes from Microsoft's forum. One person on Microsoft's forum mentioned that doing a system restore to a recent date when our computer was working properly could solve the problem. Another person who tried this also shared that doing this solved the problem. Since it is not possible to recording while doing this, I will leave a link in the description. From there, you can open this site and try this solution as well. We have come to the end of the video. I hope one of these solutions fixed your problem. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care and see you in the next video.